Good morning, Gateway Church. It is the last day of August 2020. It's Monday and it's time for our soap reading. And I am excited to be on my porch this morning with a sweatshirt on. I love these cooler mornings. I love the season that we're heading into. Today, our soap reading is in Luke chapter 13 and 14. And my attention really came to Luke chapter 14, verses 7 through 14. I want to encourage you to read that. It's really a story about Jesus teaching on humility. And historically in my life, that has been something that I have had to learn and relearn. I've often said that I've had to work on my ego. I've had to really keep that in check, and certainly is a good reminder this morning. So the story here is that there's a banquet, a dinner party, a kind of a wedding feast. And it says, when you're invited into a wedding feast, don't sit at the seat of honor. So you don't walk in and look for the best seat and say, oh, that's where I'll sit. That's where I'm supposed to be, right? Instead, take the lowest place at the foot of the table. And then it goes on to say that if you do that and you're supposed to be at the head of the table, someone will come and bring you to that point and it'll be an honoring thing. Otherwise, if you sit at the seat of honor, and they say, well, excuse me, someone else, you took someone else's seat, it's going to embarrass you. And then in verse 11 is kind of the first key takeaway. It says, for those who exalt themselves will be humbled. If you exalt yourself, if you puff yourself up, if you put yourself in a spot where you are trying to strive for something that is not yours, you will be humbled. But then it says, and those who humble themselves will be exalted. If you want to be exalted, you humble yourself. You stay humble. You keep your ego in check and you take the lower spot. And then later in that same passage in 13 and 14, I think it says that if you're throwing a party yourself, don't invite the rich people and the cream of the crop or the brass, so to speak. Instead, in verse 13, it says, invite the poor, the crippled, the lame, and the blind. And the idea here is invite those that can't pay you back. The combination of this really spoke to me this morning, challenging me to look for those that are less fortunate. Look for ways that I can serve. Look for ways that I can make a difference. And then also make sure that I am keeping my own pride, my own ego in check. And I love the verse that says, humble yourself in the sight of the Lord, and He will lift you up. Ultimately, we want to see God work in our lives. I know that that's my heart, and I know it's yours as well. And when you do that, when you say, all right, I'm going to humble myself in the sight of the Lord, He, at the right time, will take care of you. You might think, oh, I'm getting the raw end of a deal, or I need to really put myself in a spot. And the scripture over and over just says, look, take your time, let God do the promotion, you be faithful, and I know that I needed to hear that. So scripture, it's Luke chapter 14, verses 7 through 14, read it. The observation is that we need to not exalt ourselves. The application is to stay humble, and Lord, help us to do that. And let me pray. Lord, I thank you for this morning, for the beautiful day that it is that you're giving us here in West Michigan. And Lord, I pray that you would just keep our hearts pure, keep our hearts really in tune with you. And Lord, I pray that you would help me and others keep their ego in check. Lord, I thank you for teaching on humility. Lord, we want to heed these things and put these things into practice in our lives. Lord, we love you. We thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.